What I want to try and do is replace the seat. Now, I love this seat because it's the original. I'm not going to get rid of it or throw it away or anything like that. And eventually, excuse me, because I know how to sew, I may recover this and then weld some brackets on here so I can have a seat belt, because that's a big part of this for me. Now that these windows are in, it gets really hot in there, so I'm likely gonna have to drive with the doors open from time to time. Also, I don't have turn signals at the moment, so I like to open this door and stick my hand out and let people know what I'm doing, right? So I bought a while back a generic tractor seat. It slides front and back, of course. It has armrests, a lap belt. It also tilts in the back, but I think it's made kind of crappy and that'll fail eventually. But the fact that it has a seat belt is what I'm happiest about. So I was just looking here. This whole frame here is held onto this base with these bolts right here. They're quite rusty, but I'm gonna hit them right now with some peanut butter blaster. It's PB blaster. I call it peanut butter blaster, right? Just kind of get it on there, on the heads if I can, because it'll seep in, right, through capillary action. And then I'll let it sit. I'll go inside, eat, do my thing, and then come back and see if they just come right off. Hopefully they do. And I don't want to destroy anything, because if I mess this up and I can't get the other seat on, I'm kind of screwed. I can't drive. I got nothing to sit on. You know what I mean? Part of me is like, don't do this today, because the show is next Saturday. But I think I'll be all right. All right. First thing I'm going to do is remove the highly sophisticated seat retention system. They're called zip ties. They just keep the actual bottom of the seat on. When I bought the thing, the seat was just kind of sitting on top of it, so it was even worse. But this was good enough for now, because I want to see what's going on here as much as I can. I'm a little concerned about trying to remove these. I have put more peanut butter blaster on it. Ouch. Sorry. Old people pains from sitting cross-legged. I just call it peanut butter blaster. You don't have to. Yeah, I'm concerned about taking those out, because if they strip or break or whatever, I don't have a seat at all, and I'd rather have what I've got now than nothing. Where am I? Come on. Yamoto. Do you love when you smash your finger doing the simplest things? I do. Don't you love that you can cuss in a different language, so most people don't understand you? I do too. All right, ta-da! So this is the original seat, by the way. It has the springs. I did a little bit of a repair on it when I first got it. You can see these little zip ties. This was broken, so I put a piece of tubing on it and zip tied it, but it's since pulled out. So this does need attention, but I love that it's original. So here's what we've got on the tops. All right, these bolts right here. Let me squeeze a little PB blaster in there. So here's my issue. Here's the seat I want to put on. It's upside down right now. It's got these two rails, right, which allow it to slide. That's the adjuster, so you move it and you can slide the seat front and back. My issue is this. These sets of holes are 9 1/4 inches apart. If only they were 8 1/4 inches apart, because from here to there is 8 1/4, No. Yes. But 9 1/4 is from the very edge of this to the very edge of that. So they would sit just on past this. That's okay support-wise, I believe. We'll see. But maybe not, right? So, and then there's this. See how there's this hump? Hump-to-dump right there. So I want to remove this to see how that's going to sit on here. And then if necessary, I've got some heavy gauge steel from old road signs, as well as some diamond plate that I'm thinking I could bolt a strip in here. And in here, you know, bolt it down to the base and then drill the hole I need to then have the new seat have an attachment point. So that's the plan, but I need to get this off, and I need to get it off without breaking it. Now, I guess worst comes to worst, I can go get new bolts, because I wasn't sure if these were fixed or if they were bolts. So they look like bolts. So, yeah, let's do that. Okay, first thing I want to do is just tap these. That shocks them, so that if the rust is holding it, you know, that penetrating fluid is breaking that up, and then the shock helps too. And then lightly on the bottom, not hard, like I'm not smashing, I'm just tapping. I don't want to mushroom over the threads, in other words. Alright, now let's see, I'm gonna hold you in my hands, hug you, squeeze you, I've got my wrench here, I think I muffled it, it's a half inch, let's see, oh no, sorry, I grabbed the wrong one, it's a 7/16 like I used earlier on the door. I want to use this instead of a socket because I feel like I'll have better feel. Oh, all right. The whole thing spun, but that's good. I'll have to hold the top down. All right. The whole bolt and nut is spinning. That's something, at least. I don't know what's going to happen when I try. Alright, that one's nice and moving. So's that. Alright. That's probably the most these things have moved in 60 years. Alright, let me get a socket for the top. And then I'll try and remove the bottom, or vice versa. Okay, I'm gonna hold the bolt at the top and try and spin it underneath. Now with the socket. Oh, that's going. Nice. Let's see if I can loosen them all up. Oba. Yeah, that's loosening up. Beautiful. Gorgeous. Oh, mail call. Hey! I took them all off except this last one. I got my mail and then I just started kind of going for it. But they've all come out thus far. I'm on the last one. And it feels good. So we got very lucky. I'm sure this thing hasn't come off since it was put on. So it's just a U-bracket like that over the pipe. I marked where each one sat in case I have to put it back together. So now this should, if you want to look here, the adjuster knob here, right, is that rod goes into that. So if I pick that out, oh, I'll get hit in the head. There we go. Okay. So there's the original seat frame. Kind of cool, huh? It's sturdy. It's steel, that's for sure. A little bit of a tear. Like I said, I may recover this eventually and weld some attachment points for even a three-point belt. Let's see what this says on the... Hard to read. Something Merrick Seat, Grand Rapids, Michigan. I'm guessing it says American Seat Co. Who knows? Anyway, that was the original seat. It's neat, it's sturdy, but it's dangerous as heck. I guess people didn't fly out of their seats in the 60s. This is kind of neat. It has, these are some kind of plastic poly shim that it was bolted onto, so that's kind of cool. Put those to the side. I do want to clean this up a little. With the windows being open for how many years, this thing is just... collected all sorts of dirt and all of its nooks and crannies. All right. So let me bring the other seat over. Man, this thing is the hardest to move. I guess that's good because it doesn't, it's not going to smash you forward every time you hit the brakes, but dang. Okay, I'm going to put you on the tripod and then sit that seat on there and see what we get. Cross your fingers. What do we got? Wow, that's it's just like just at the edge. Here, let me show you. It looks good though, right? Like it fits the truck. I just hope it's comfy in that the old seat had springs, right? So you'd bounce a little. This will be hard mounted. All right, don't fall on my head. So you see how that's just over the edge, and that's just over the edge. But, so what I think I'm gonna do, mentioned earlier, I can cut two pieces of something, and they can go from here and extend out to about there, right? And they'll bolt, these original bolt holes, I can bolt it down to the pedestal through at least one of the original bolt holes in the front and the back, if not both, right? I think I can't do both because it'll be in the way of the rails. And then, oh, that's just not gonna make it. See, the issue is, it's just, I didn't wanna drill. That's what I also do. My goodness, God help me, hang on. You stare at that for a second while I do this. Oh my goodness. Danger. Danger! Alright. Come here. Wherever I had it was good. Now it's not like staying at all. I guess I got lucky. Okay, welcome back. So you see how half that hole is visible? And half those holes are visible. These are the mounting holes for these rails. I can't. I'm going to have to partially drill through that. And I don't want to do that. I just don't. I mean, I guess I could. On this side, it'll be tricky because this is here and I don't want to cut that off. Gosh, I hate to... I just don't want to ruin the original stuff as much as I can get away with, you know? But I would have to drill at least half a hole here and there to make this fit or bolt down. Wait, hang on. Hang on. I'm going to put you on the tripod. My brain is working. I need both hands for this because I don't want to smash myself. What if I do this? So, again... I'll cut the piece that'll mount there. But let's see, if I bring this back far enough, I have access to a whole, tricky. So if I sit this centered between the rail, can you see, right? Dang it, I don't want to smash myself. So if I do that, my diamond plate, as long as I bring it out far enough, I can mount there and there and there and there, and also have it mounted with four bolts to this, and problem solved. Look at that. Look at that. All right, let's straighten this out just a smidge. About even, doesn't have to be perfect. See, the thing is too, the seat has adjustment. I think it can go, I don't know if that's as far forward as it'll go. Almost beamed myself. Oh, this is... I think I need it to go forward one click. There we go. So I think this is as far back as it'll go. And then it'll go more forward. But yeah, I like that. Because the rails are going to stay in place. It's the seat that's going to move, right? So if I have that right about there, let's say. I'm just looking at this one. A little bit more. Right about there. That kind of almost splits the difference. Tape measure. That's 1 7/8. That's 1 1/4. So I can move forward a little. 1 5/8. 1 5/8. Great. So if I extend 2 inches front and back, right? So that would be, come on. That's a foot. So 14 inches front to back. And roughly, let's say it only has to be 3 inches wide. 3 inches wide, right? A little bit more. Go 4 inches wide and 14. 4 by 14. I think that'll do it. Sweet. All right. I'll be right back. Okay, so I have it set up right now. This is the side that really matters because this is attached to the seat base, whereas the other one just sliding all over the place for the moment. So I'm splitting the difference between this end of the rail and the front end of the rail, 1 5/8. That's all have the best support, you know. This is with the seat all the way back. I can't really touch the pedals, and there's maybe 3 or 4 inches of distance between my feet. Now, I don't think I'm going to grow any taller anytime soon. But, you know, if somebody very, very tall, like a 6-foot person should be comfortable in this seat, maybe just under 6 feet. I don't know why that matters. I'm making it for me. With this in the fully forward position, I'm like driving like a whole man, like with the steering wheel in my gut, right? So there's plenty of room to move forward. And for myself, I need the room to go forward more than backward. So for that reason and for the equal distribution, I'm gonna leave it there. So when I measure this distance from here, so again, this bottom rail does not move, from here to there is exactly 12 inches. I'm gonna cut a piece 12 and an eighth just to give me a little extra. And then the width is about 3 1/4 is a good width, because I don't want it too far past this rail, because I don't want it getting in the way of me actuating that handle, right? So 3 1/4 will allow me to bolt into that hole and that hole, and attach here and there, and have just a little sticking out, just in case. I mean, I could cut it at 3 1/8 even, and it might be even better, right? And then the same thing here, 3 1/8 would be just even, Steven, and 12 inches. So that's that. I like it. Okay, here's where we're at. I have two pieces of this beat up diamond plate. It's only about 10 1/4 wide. It's not long enough for the 12 1/8 length we need. So what I'm gonna do is cut the length here, and I'm gonna cut out these holes, and then I still have enough here for 3 1/4 and 3 1/4, or I might even go 3 1/8 and 3 1/8, and then I can drill out the holes. I think that'll look kind of cool. I was gonna use some signage I have, but I hate to cut like a perfectly good old road sign for just a couple of little strips. The reason I was hesitant to use this, on the back of the step van, there's a gap where the rear bumper should be. What was that? You want to see what I'm talking about?
Okay.
So, over here. Oh, hello, Royal Enfield Continental GT650. So, you see this gap right there? It's all rusty. I want to clean that up. I've got to get rid of all this stupid wiring. I got to reroute this. That's for the plugs inside the truck. Anyway, got to patch that too. But one piece of that diamond plate actually is, unfortunately, an inch too short to go from end to end. So what I think I'm going to do is cut two pieces that are half the distance and mount one and then the other, just so it butts up to the end here. And it's okay if there's a seam, but I have enough to cut out what I'm cutting out right now, and then have plenty to do what I just talked about. So I marked this off. I'm gonna go over to the bandsaw and start a cutting. I'm not gonna film all of the cutting. I just want you to see what I'm doing. And please excuse the cluster F. I'm still waiting for the weather to cool down so I can finish my workshop, so a lot of this stuff can go into the workshop.
Okay.
So I cut this down. It's a little tricky because the throat of the bandsaw only goes so far, so I had to cut the rest of this out with a cutting wheel. Anyway, so now I'm ready to cut my strip. I did compare it to the seat. Everything looks good. So I'm gonna cut my two pieces and we'll go from there. So what I'm gonna do now, I have everything cut. We're gonna go the diamond side down so people can see it and go, wow, isn't that cool? I'm gonna place this on here, and equidistant from the edges. Gonna measure it, and then I will draw in these two holes so I can drill them out. And then I'll mount it, or I might be able to put this on here too, and just mark those holes as well. But I do think I'll drill these first, mount it, and then do the rest. Okay. Should be about an inch and 5/8. Oh, I can't see. I need my tape measure. I can't see these numbers. They're too dark. Here you are. Oh yeah, I cut it a little over 12, so inch and 2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 11/16. Inch and 11/16. That's good. Put a make sure it's sitting flat, because there is a, it curves up here, and then I've got one, and two, double check from the top, yes. Put an arrow and put an L for left. Do the same thing on this side. Got my little marks. Okay, I'll do the same for the other side. Drill these out, mount them, and go from there. Okay, actually what I did was I flipped these over in this, you know, they're in the same distance where they should be, because you can't punch a hole there. So I did it on the flat side on both of them. I'm going to center punch. Just got to get you out of my way. Nice. I wasn't sure if this was stainless or aluminum, but I'm certain it's aluminum because of how easily it cut. I would really like to get an optical punch, because you can be super precise. Even here, you're eyeballing it, and if it's off a little, like this one, off, and then what do, right? Okay, now I'm going to just use a drill with a smaller bit on it as a pilot hole, and then I'll use this. I'm drilling them 1/4 inch because I want to reuse the original hardware if I can, as much as I can, because A, I think that'll be cool, and B, I won't lose it. I was like this, don't do that, you smash your hands. Smash your hands! That's the nice thing with aluminum, I kind of guided it so it would be more centered. I have a really rad center drill, but it's on the fritz and I haven't had a chance to fix it. That'll be another video. Nice. And look, there were my front holes just about were. So we're on the right track. Now 1/4 inch. see, I pushed down just a little bit after it drilled and it kind of beveled that edge. And now I'll clean up this edge the same way. All right, I'll drill out the other one and then we'll start mounting stuff. Okay. All right, I cleaned this up a little. Oh, and I had a brainstorm. You know, these little plastic, whatever they are. These are so the other seat could slide, because it would slide on top of this. There you go. So, I've got the right front. And I know it's not gonna sit totally flat because of the diamond, but it's okay here. Bolt. Gonna reuse the old bolts because I like them. Nice. And I don't know if I have the right size bolts. At least for my test fitting purposes. All right. And then this one, left front. Plus, they're already rusty, so it'll, it matches everything else. My holes line up, so that's good. Happy about that. Tighten these up. I'm not gonna kill him, just gonna snug it just a little. Want him to have just a little bit of play necessary. Okay, do the other side and I'll bring you right back. All right, these are on. Let's put the seat on. There's a big storm coming in, so I don't know if we're going to get rained on and I'll have to run away. Oh, wrong way. Oops. Nice. So I'm putting the rails about center for them now. And here we go. It's not heavy, it's just cumbersome. The one on the left side like just slides, so it's kind of annoying. Okay, so if you can see, the seat actually seats in its own seatness. Ooh, rain's coming. I'm gonna say goodbye for the moment. Okay, I started working again. The storm kind of passed, but it's very windy. So while I was still outside and I had the seat on top of these as they were mounted in place, I marked where the rails went, and the rails are basically the same on both sides. So the one that just comes in and out all the time without even asking, I'm putting that down. I marked where it sat when the seat was in place, and I am then going to mark the outermost spots where I can drill. And on both of them and do that. Okay, so you're in my way, but it's all right, don't take it personally. I'm right there. Just going front and back. I'm just basically everything's going to be equidistant, right? So I've got a hole right there, and I'm going to reuse the bolts and nuts that were originally there. I mean, should I put new ones? Because maybe they'd be stronger or something. I don't know. But I don't have any other ones, so I'm going to use those because I have them. And like I said, I know where they are. They won't get lost. Although I do have like these big storage bins for every vehicle I own. And anything I take off that is worth keeping goes in those bins. But nonetheless. Can you see what I'm doing? Here, center. So I know where you are at all times. Heads in the way, heads out of the way. Okay, and they do have to be kind of straight. So this is the front. Just have it turned around. This is the back. And like before, center punch, gut punch, center punch. The Bosque Farms car show next weekend, August 5th, 2023. Looking forward to it. That's what I'm doing. I mean, I wanted to do all this work to the Grumman nonetheless, but I wanted to definitely have it ready for the show. Okay. I may have dulled this. Don't know how. Cheap. That's how. It's supposed to be titanium. Yeah, I don't think so. You get the picture. Okay. So I thought I'd just film this whole thing, but I didn't. So this wire was connected in here. It goes to a dead man switch in the seat. So when you're driving a forklift, you actually have to sit in the seat, and that switch then allows the forklift to be driven and operated. I cut it off, but I left about that much excess and just tucked it inside. This way, if for some crazy reason someday I want to hook that up because I'm gonna change seats and blah blah blah, who knows, I have enough that'll stick out that I can solder to these ends. All right, let's go back to the step van and get it going. I'm ready. It's kind of windy, sorry, and it's starting to drizzle again. Anyway, I have the seat sitting on the pedestal, and what I want to do now is I have just enough room here to install the bolt in the back. I'm going to do that, and then I will have to, so this side is easier, I can just slide it in and out. This side, I have to manipulate it, you know. Let's see what I got going on here. All right, that's good. So again, it doesn't matter where the seat, if it's forward or back. I just need these rails to be in place. And what I'm doing with these bolts, I'm using the originals, but I'm putting a washer on each one to sit inside the rail to give a better purchase. There we go. And I'm going to use a lock washer as well on each one just to be on the safe side. The interesting part's going to be tightening this down. Let's get that one started. I think my wrench should just fit in there, and it does. They thought of everything. This is all cattywampus right now. But let me get this one started. I'm not going to snug it down, obviously. Just enough to have it not be floppy. And then we'll move that over, push that forward, and put in the next screw in the back here. I also put a drop of 3-in-1 oil on the threads of all of these screws because they're so old. They just need whatever love they can get. You know, we all need some love, don't we? There we go. That's two. Hopefully the front ones are just as easy. I don't see why they wouldn't be. Unless my holes are in the wrong place. Out of four. Now we'll slide the seat back. Or is that as far back as it goes? And am I screwed now? Couldn't be that easy, could it? Can you see? My memory card filled up, kind of like my brain. That one just popped in. Let's see if I can get the other one in. I hope I didn't screw this up, in other words. All right, the holes all line up. That's great. I guess this is as far back as it can go, or so I think. Let's put these two on. I don't think I screwed up though. Again, I'm more concerned with it sliding forward. Sorry, it's windy. Okay, it's done. I did have to take the bolts back out because with the washers in there, that's why I couldn't slide it front and back. It's not that it was at its final spot. It's that it was grabbing the washers, but now it's fine. So let me go sit in it and try it out. I like it. It's comfy. I was worried it wouldn't be high enough because the other seat was really tall, but I really like where this puts me. My mirrors are still in a good spot. Wow. And I have a seat belt. I'm protected. Let's see if I can make it a little tighter. My keto diet seems to be working. Wow, look at that. Can I go a little further? I don't know if you could see my face, but I'm smiling. Oh, I'm so happy. And I have armrests. I love armrests because I'm all like this. Wow. Okay, we'll see how long this seat lasts. I'm going to call it a day. Thanks for hanging out. I don't know if you could hear everything I just said because it's windy, but I'm super happy. It fits great. It slides far forward enough. It's comfy. It's high enough. I thought it was going to be too low. I love having arms and I love having a seatbelt. This is so cool. It was pretty straightforward too. A couple of hiccups, but nothing we couldn't get past. I love having that diamond plate under there and how simple a fix that was, right? All right, folks. Thank you so much for hanging out. Let me know if you have any questions and I'll talk to you another time. Oh, and by the way, that seat is made by a company called Vevor, V-E-V-O-R. I'll put it down below. Take care. Talk to you soon. Bye.